Welcome to the MOOCs course Mechanical Unit Operations. Myself, Nanda Kishore. I am a professor of Department of Chemical Engineering, IIT Guwahati. Mechanical Unit Operations is a core compulsory course for undergraduate students of chemical engineering. So in this introduction video, in this particular introduction video, we are going to see how much this course is important, why it is a kind of core course for chemical engineering discipline. That is what we are going to see now. Right. So, what is the general perspective of chemical engineering? In general, in chemical engineering, what we do or what we expect, like, you know, what happens in chemical plants is, in general, raw materials are converted or separated into useful products. That is basically, that is what we see. Not a kind of exact definition, but that is what, in general, we have a feel about the chemical engineering. Chemical engineering plants, what chemical engineer is expected to do, in general, develop, design and engineer both the complete process as well as the individual equipment are used for a chemical plant. The entire details the chemical engineer must have. The chemical engineer must have a kind of knowledge about the selection of raw material as per the requirement of the products. Then chemical engineer is expected to perform, operate the plants with primarily the safety, then efficiency, then economically feasible way that a chemical plant has to be operated by the chemical engineer. And then finally, the chemical engineer has to check whether the products are meeting the requirements of the consumer or not. Those things are expected to be done by the chemical engineer in general. Right? So then what we have, in general, in many material process engineering industries, not only just in a kind of chemical engineering plants, but so many other kind of material processing industries as well, we find that the chemical engineering is having a kind of vital role. What are those kind of processing industries or material processing industries that we have a kind of where the chemical engineering role is very much important? So we'll have some of them kind of list out here. So some common processes and industries where chemical engineering plays a vital role are manufacturing of organic and inorganic chemicals. That is basically, that is what about the chemical engineering about. Wherever the manufacturing of some kind of organic or inorganic material is there, chemicals are there. So there we will definitely have a role of chemical engineering. Something like, you know, production of sodium hydroxide, production of sulfuric acid, methyl alcohol, polyethylene, etc. Then chemical engineering is also having a kind of important role in other disciplines, like, you know, petroleum refining. In petroleum refining, something like, you know, conversion of crude into products such as kerosene, gasoline, benzene, toluene, etc. So there also so many principles of chemical engineering are in general applied. Likewise, in metallurgical industries as well, we have something like, you know, ore beneficiation, etc. There also we use a kind of chemical engineering principles in general to have a kind of those processes happening efficiently, something like processing of iron ores, etc. Like this, if we keep on listing the process industries or material industries where chemical engineering principles are very much applied, very much important, the list goes on. Almost all material processing industries, we find the principles of chemical engineering are going to, playing a kind of very important vital role. And then some of them, a few more material processing industries are something like, you know, polymer industry, pharmaceutical industry, food industry, polymer processing industry, textile industry, and so on. So what we realize in not only in pure chemical plants, but also in many other material processing plants as well, the chemical engineering principles are very much important. In general, what we have in a chemical plant, in general, the chemical plants consist of unit operations and unit processes. Unit processes are the units where the reactions are taking place. Unit operations are the operations where physical or mechanical changes are only occurring, and those physical or mechanical changes may be occurring only because of the mechanical forces or by some kind of molecular transport mechanism, etc. Right? So that is what we have. So the chemical plants, we can categorize as that reaction part, before the reaction part, and then after the reaction part. So upstream processes, that is pre-processing of raw materials. So where in general, from natural resources, whatever the raw materials that we get, they are not in a kind of refined form suitable for a kind of reaction. So we need to do a kind of thorough processing of those raw materials so that to make them suitable for the reaction. So those upstream processes, we call them as pre-processing of raw materials. So there we have several unit operations, such as, you know, crushing, grinding, washing, filtration, drying, mixing, etc. Then these processed raw materials, what we can do, we can take them to the unit processes where the reaction taking place. So the converting the processed raw materials to products is taking place in the unit processes, or these unit processes describe the kind of reactions, right? So here the reactions such as oxygenation, hydrogenation, polymerization, etc., these kind of chemical reactions occur in these unit processes. Right? When there is a reaction taking place, it is not necessary that the 100% conversion will take place, right? So it is also not possible that always you have a only desired product is coming out of the reaction. There may be some kind of byproducts as well, right? So then after the reaction, we need to take out, separate the products from the unreacted reactants as well as the from the byproducts. So unreacted reactants may be fed back to the reactor again, in order to have the reaction further processing, and then byproducts has to be separated from the product so that the product can be collected and then supplied to the consumer as per the requirement of the consumer. So that is the third process. Downstream processes is the post processing of products. In the downstream processes, that is after the reaction, we need to do this kind of post-processing of products, such as for this purpose also we have several kind of unit operations like distillation, evaporations, extraction, settling, granulation, centrifugation, etc. So what we see here in the chemical plants, two kind of operations are taking place. One of those operations are only mechanical or physical changes are only occurring. The other kind of operations where only the reactions are taking place. Right, so that is how we can divide chemical plants as a kind of consisting of several unit operations and then several unit processes. Indeed, only a few unit processes are there, but there are many dozens of unit operations are involved in any kind of chemical plant. That is the reason the course related to the unit operations are also kind of core important courses at the undergraduate level of chemical engineering. And then these unit operations are basically kind of, you know, based on the purely mechanical forces or based on the molecular transport mechanism. So some of the unit operations which are also based on the molecular transport mechanisms, such as distillation, evaporation, etc., drying, etc., they are taken into the other kind of core courses, that is in the mass transfer or heat transfer kind of courses they have been taken, right? And then the unit operations which are only based on the mechanical forces, they are taken as part of the mechanical unit operation course. That is the reason this mechanical unit operations is also a kind of very much important and essential course. So now, how do you define the unit operation? So how we can define these unit operations? After seeing these chemical plants having the unit process and unit operations, we can define these unit operations. Our unit operations are used to describe a physical or mechanical procedure occurring individually or parallel to some kind of chemical reaction. They may occur individually or they may also occur parallel to some kind of chemical reactions in general. Or they basically, these unit operations are used to conduct the physical steps of preparing reactants, that is before the reaction. Properly preparing the raw material suitable for the reaction, that physical steps of preparing reactants. Then after the reaction, separating of products from the byproducts, as well as the purification of these products, that is what we do using the same these kind of unit operations again. Then unreacted whatever the reactants are there, recycling back to the process in order to have them further reaction occurring. Then in the reactor, usually you may be giving energy or taking out energy, so the controlling of that energy transfer into or out of the reactor is also a kind of a unit operation, and then that is also very much essential. So this is what in general is about the unit operations. So, what is mechanical unit operation? Mechanical unit operations are the operations which are purely based on physical or mechanical forces, such as a gravitational force or centrifugal force or a kind of mechanical and kinetic forces arising from the flow. So, if the unit operations are occurring because of these forces, so then we call those unit operations as a kind of mechanical unit operations. The unit operations which are causing because of the molecular transport mechanism, usually we call them as a stage operations or separation operations, which are in general used in mostly in heat mass transfer and in heat transfer part. Then, based on the phases interacting, these mechanical unit operations may be classified as solid-solid operations as well as the solid-fluid operations, right? So, under the solid-solid operations, we have a few operations. Under the solid-fluid operations, we have the kind of few operations, right? Under the solid-solid operations, we have whatever the natural resource, bulk raw material is there, crushing them into the smaller particle size, then grinding, sieving, compaction, cutting, storage, transport of these bulk solids, etc., all that come into the solid-solid operations. And then under the solid-fluid operations, we have operations like filtration, sedimentation, centrifugation, flotation, cyclone separators, etc. So, the structure of this particular course has been divided into two parts. This mechanical unit operation course that I am going to teach, I will be teaching in two different parts. Like, you know, first five modules will be dedicated to the mechanical unit operations where solid-solid phases are interacting, and then sixth, seventh module we'll be discussing some basic about the fluid particle systems, single and multiple particles in fluid interaction. Those kind of systems we develop working basic equations, and then those basics of the fluid particle mechanics, they will be used for the kind of designing and then developing the working principles of the solid fluid operations in the remaining last five modules, 5 weeks. So, this mechanical unit operation course having the solid-solid operations as well as the solid fluid operations. So, coming to the contents, we have the 12 modules. The first module is introduction of particulate solids, where we will be discussing the introduction about the course, then unit operations involving the particulate solids, then characteristics of the particulate solids, etc. Then we have a screening, then size reduction, storage and conveying of the bulk solids, size enlargement. Up to this fifth module, we have only solid-solid operations. Then sixth and seventh modules, we'll be discussing about the fluid particle mechanics. And then using those fluid particle basics, what we'll do, we will be using those basics that we study in the sixth and seventh module for developing the processes or designing the remaining separation process, like filtration, other kind of separation processes like gravity sedimentation process, centrifugal separations, flotations, etc. For this particular course, I'll be using these many books. Six books primarily have been referred. The first one is The Unit Operations of Chemical Engineering by McCabe, Smith and Harriet. Then the second one, Unit Operations of Particulate Solids, Theory and Practice by Ortega-Rivas. And then we have a Carlson and Richardson Chemical Engineering series, second volume by Richardson and Harker. Then we have Transport Processes and Unit Operations by C.J. John Copley's. Then we have Unit Operations by Brown et al. Then finally, we have Introduction to Chemical Engineering by Badger and Banchero. Thank you.